A very good evening to you. You're watching Prime Time News on News First. I'm Chaturanga Porachi.
And I'm Dasmiya Thala. Well, surely the Christmas festivities are in full swing here at the square. Let's start off with tonight's headlines.
Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe says he will form a new party named the National Democratic Front. JVP to move resolution to dissolve parliament following 20th Amendment. Cabinet may be sworn in tomorrow. Signs of crossovers. UPFA says cabinet cannot have more than 30 members as it is not a national government. Corruption allegations against former president of the Maldives. Personal accounts frozen.
Taking a look at those stories in detail now, a public rally organized by the United National Front under the theme The Public Rally for the Victory of Justice was held at the Goldface Green in Colombo today. The rally was held under the auspices of the Prime Minister and UMP leader Ranil Wickremesinghe.
A vehicular parade got underway near the UNP headquarters Sirikota today, intending to arrive at the rally following a tour of Colombo. Several leaders of the United National Front, including the deputy leader of the UNP, Sajith Premadasa, participated in the rally. Our challenge is not the Sri Lanka Freedom Party. The challenge we have to face is the Podujana Peramuna and the Rajapaksas. In the next 6 months, we will work for the party faithful. If we are giving a job, it will be for the party faithful. We will search out the party faithful to offer them jobs. We know how to face this. Our leader is a superb playmaker. I say clearly that there is no one in Sri Lanka who can play the game with Ranil Wickremesinghe. There was an era when even people like us were placed in the dustbin by jealous politicians. I wish to say here happily that because of the support of the people who voted for us, our party and our leader, who put all of that to aside for our country, we were able to turn that defeat into a victory. If there were delays in the things we did before, we ask for your forgiveness. I wish to say before you now that within the next 1.5 years, we will fulfill all the promises we made to you. I was not given a chance to even see my father's body. All I could see was a sealed coffin. I will not betray my father. I will not betray my mother who is still among the living. I will not betray my soul ever. I say to you now that if I ever get to a position, it will be on your shoulders. I swear to you now that just as we form the government, we will now distribute land to the ordinary people by the bushel. I say to you now that I will also begin the Gamudava 20,000 project, which will bring victory to you by 2025. This is a new approach. There is no space for thievery and thuggery. There will be no commissions or extortion. I say now that we must spend even our personal wealth for the people of our country to protect the people of our country. It is the pan that lies between the fire and the hopper. It is the pan that must face the fire. We face the fire of democracy. We want reconciliation in this country. We want a political solution in this country. I say that we will put forward that solution under a unitary state. We will not let go of that. I ask that you give us a 2/3 majority at the parliamentary election. We cannot do this while being beholden to others. I say that we must even accomplish the abolition of the executive presidency on our own. We will now form a new alliance and register it as a political party. This is the National Democratic Front. Our lawyers are drafting the final clauses. On Friday, I will present this resolution to our working committee, and I have no doubt that all of us will come together to form a large alliance to bring about democracy.
ප්‍රජාතන්ත්‍රවාදී ඇතිකරන්න විශාල සම්දානයක් ඇති කරගන්න.
MPs of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party met with President Maithripala Sirisena at the Presidential Secretariat this evening. Following the meeting, several MPs expressed the following views.
As a group of 21 from the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, we decided to sit at the opposition. We have made our decision and we will be committed to work on uplifting the party. The President, the group of 21 and the SLFP reached an agreement and this will be confirmed at the Central Working Committee. Neither cabinet, ministerial, deputy ministerial nor state ministerial positions will be accepted. We will remain as members of parliament. We decided to function as the opposition and obtain the opposition leader and the chief opposition whip positions. There will not be a governing party in parliament tomorrow, so the parliament shouldn't even be convened tomorrow. But we will attend the parliamentary session and sit at the opposition.
The United National Party says the cabinet of ministers will be sworn in tomorrow. The UPFA says the cabinet should be limited to 30 ministers. Now, meanwhile, rumors are abound that several MPs may join the government. This is what the UNP had to say about this.
We have formed a government and now we will appoint a cabinet. We are trying as far as possible to appoint a cabinet of no more than 30 members and to have no more than 40 state and deputy ministers. However, we are also holding discussions with other parties. People are asking whether the SLFP will join us too. If we are to bring them in, then we will do so with extreme caution. We will hold interviews and take only the good people.
ප්‍රමාදීදී හරියට මේක හදාගන්න බෑ පිළිවෙලකට විද්‍යාත්මක විද්‍යානුකූලව ප්‍රායෝගිකව දැන්
චෝදනාවක් තියෙනවා රවි කරුණායක
මහත්තයා මොකද්ද රවි කරුණායක ඔබට චෝදනාවක් තියෙන්නේ
බඳුන් කරවා
නෑ එතුමාට කිසිම චෝදනාවක් නෑ එතුමාට නීතිපතිවරයාගේ විමසලා තිබුණා එතුමාට කැබිනට් ඇමතිකමක් දැරිය හැකිදයි විමසීමක් කරලා තිබුණා මේක කිසි ප්‍රශ්නයක් නෑ
නෑ
මුදල් ඇමතිකමද මොන ඇමතිකමද දන්නේ නෑ ඒක හරිද ඒක මම දන්නේ නෑ නමුත් එතුමාට අමාත්‍ය මණ්ඩලයේ තනතුරක් දැරීමට කිසිම නුසුසුකමක් නැහැ. අනිවාර්යයෙන් ලැබෙනවා.
ඒ වගේම තමයි මලික ඇමතිතුමාලා
මලික ඇමතිතුමාට අනිවාර්යෙන් එතුමා හොඳ අමාත්‍යවරයෙක් එතුමාට සම්මෙන්න උනායි මොකද තියෙන ප්‍රශ්නේ මන්ද.
Mehema. Discussions are currently underway with the other side. We are trying our best to keep this to 30. If we are unable to do so, then using the parliamentary majority, we can approve an increase to up to 35 members. Although there are about 20 who are prepared to come as a party or a group, we have rejected taking them in as a party or a group. I will not say who, but there was major opposition to some individuals there from our parliamentary group. They will most probably join as individuals. We will not take those whom we oppose and we will take those who meet the minimum qualifications following interviews.
The United People's Freedom Alliance says the number of ministerial portfolios cannot be increased without forming a national government.
According to Section 46(1) in the Constitution, the maximum number of ministers can only be 30, including the President and the Prime Minister. There is an attempt to give out ministries to a few from the Alliance to indicate that it is not a government that is centered around the TNA. There are only 28 people remaining to do all of this. It was reported that the UNP is trying to focus on the Muslim Congress and are holding discussions to join hands with Ali Zahir Maulana to form a national government. Therefore, we urge the President to prevent the UNP from increasing the maximum number of ministerial portfolios of 28. Only the President can prevent this from happening.
Sri Lanka Miss Muslim.
There is no possibility to go beyond that maximum limit by signing an agreement with the Sri Lanka Muslim Congress. If that happens, the identity of those parties will be lost. All those parties contested as an alliance under the elephant. Now their intention is to go beyond that limit of 30 by some ploy. President Maithripala Sirisena has very clearly said this in a statement. Whoever goes as a party, the UPFA will remain the same. This is the stance of President Maithripala Sirisena.
UPFA parliamentarian Mahindayapa Bewardhan expressed the following news regarding crossovers.
Sri Lanka Nidhas Pakshe.
There's a rumor that a few MPs of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party are planning to join the United National Party. We are saddened by this. We are not surprised. These type of things take place in the world. So we pray that these MPs will have the strength to fulfill their responsibilities when they come across proposals that are illegal and put forward to sell the country.
Hello there and welcome back to the news, coming to you live and direct from the Echelon Square, Chaturanga.
Yes, we have been seeing crowds gathering here to be a part of this Christmas experience here at Echelon Square in Colombo. We invite all of you as well to come here and be a part of this experience. We have our sister channels Yes FM and Legends FM on one side of Echelon Square, and we have News First on the other side, bringing you the live experience of news bulletins being telecast live on air. So we welcome all of you to come and be a part of this initiative. Dasmi?
Yes, back on to your news. As in the past, today too saw familiar scenes of members of parliament convening media briefings to assure the public that they will not be crossing over. Ratnapur district parliamentarian Premalal Jayasekara had this to say.
I must say here clearly that if I was to go, then I should have gone a long time ago. But no wrong has been done to us for us to leave, and neither do we want to leave. I must say clearly that in every instance we have acted in a blameless manner. At the same time, our party, the people of the Ratnapura district, gave me more than 154,000 votes recently. When I was in remand custody, I wish to clearly say that I will never betray these people.
ඒ නිසා ඒ ජනතාව පාවල දෙන්න අපි මොනම අවස්ථාවකද කටයුතු කරන්නේ නැහැ කියන එක පැහැදිලිවම මතක්
කරනවා. While there are various views about the new cabinet of ministers and crossovers, UPFA parliamentarian Rohitha Begunawardena had this to say.
දැන් අපි බලාගෙන ඉන්නේ කැබිනට් මණ්ඩලයේ දියුණුවන් දෙනකොට
We are waiting to see how those who approached us take oaths as new ministers of the cabinet. Those who spoke to us during the recent past requesting for many things will also take oaths. Depending on the cabinet tomorrow, we will announce their names during press conferences.
Cabinet Mandale diha balala.
Meanwhile, the UPFA is demanding the position of opposition leader in parliament, claiming that their group holds the majority in opposition.
If democracy is to be protected, consider that 101 members are in the opposition now. The opposition must be given the opposition leadership and the position of chief opposition whip. If we are not given the opposition leadership, we will not allow parliament to function. We will not allow the speaker to conduct parliament sittings. We will totally disrupt parliament.
Controversy has arisen in the political arena as a result of several SLFP members of parliament obtaining membership of the Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna, also known as the SLPP. Will the change in party membership affect their seats in parliament? Speaking at a public rally held in Homagam yesterday, Foreign Minister Basil Rajapaksa had this to say regarding the topic.
There are several MPs here who sought membership of the Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna. You have not been given membership in our party yet. We will consider it and then approve it. I must mention this. We will not give it to everyone who asks for it. The Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna is young. There are some who say that SLFP MPs joined the Sri Lanka Podujana Peramuna. It is true that they have asked to join. But I must say that they are still not members. The executive committee of our party is not like the past. You are all founding members. So they will receive their membership following some discussion.
What is the JVP's current stance on the political changes in the country? Speaking to a group of party members at the JVP office in Kaluthara today, MP Nalinda Jayasekara had this to say.
රනිල් සාගල කල්ලිය කරේ හුරු ආරක්ෂා කරපේ. ඒ විතරක් නෙමෙයි ජනවාරි 8 වෙනිදා 2015 පත් වෙලා දවස් 50ක් යනකම්
Ranil Sagala and the clan protected the thieves. Not just that, they even appointed Arjun Mahendran to rob the central bank during the first 50 days since they got elected on the 8th of January 2015. After robbing the biggest bank in the country, ethically, how can Ranil Wickremesinghe capture the thieves of the previous regime? And that's exactly how the Rajapaksas were able to save themselves from the cases against them. The main person who's accused of betraying the public mandate is Ranil Wickremesinghe. So when he assumes duties again as the Prime Minister, Ranil Wickremesinghe should at least form two special high courts before the 1st of January. The courts should take up cases on a daily basis. The FCID and the CID should be strengthened. There's a need to strengthen the Attorney General's department as well. If all of this is fulfilled only, Ranil Wickremesinghe can say that he worked according to the public mandate. Who pulled Mahinda Rajapaksa, who was a president for 2 tenures, into this conspiracy? The group, as mentioned by Kumara Welgama, who enters parliament while holding on to the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, Vasudeva Nanayakkara, Vimal Veerawansa and Uday Gammanpila got together and did this.
විමල් වීරවංශ උදේ ගම්මම් මේ තුන් කට්ටුව එකතු වෙලා මහින්ද රාජපක්ෂ මහත්තයව වැටට තියලා අමුඩ ගැහුවා. දැන් අද මහින්ද රාජපක්ෂ මහත්තයට සිද්ධ වෙලා තිබෙන්නේ
This was done by Vasudeva, Vimal and Gammanpila. Something should be done after the conspiracy is defeated. A parliamentary commission should be appointed to punish those who were involved in the conspiracy. We will put forward the proposal in the near future. Those who were involved in the conspiracy should be brought forward the law regardless of their positions and status. We have now put forward the 20th Amendment to the Constitution. With the approval of 150 MPs, the 20th Amendment will abolish the autocratic ruling of the executive presidency, which does not suit the country. During the next 6 months, we will give the opportunity to the people of this country to hold an election. The JVP is ready to bring the proposal to dissolve this and conduct a general election. So we inform the United National Party and the group with Mahinda Rajapaksa to form a two-third majority in parliament for an election.
Mahinda Rajapaksa mahathaya dina kandayamath kiyano karuna karala obe chandaya denna parliamentaya thunen deka.
Several members of the Polebadda indigenous community arrived at the Sirikota, the UNP party headquarters, today.
There were various issues with our Prime Minister. We performed a ritual in aid of the Prime Minister to overcome all these issues. That is why we came here with our children.
Then the Adivasi met the senior executive officer of the UNP, Shamal Senarath.
The delegation of the European Union issued a statement in agreement with the EU ambassadors and the Norwegian ambassador resident in Colombo.
The statement says, quote, "As steady friends of Sri Lanka, we welcome the peaceful and democratic resolution of the political crisis in accordance with the constitution. We commend the resilience of Sri Lanka's democratic institutions and will continue to support its efforts towards national reconciliation and prosperity for all," unquote. U.S. Ambassador to Sri Lanka, Elena B. Teplitz, also responded to the political situation in Sri Lanka. On Twitter, the ambassador says, quote, "The U.S. welcomes this weekend's political developments which upheld Sri Lanka's democratic and constitutional norms," unquote. It added, quote, "Sri Lanka is a valued partner in the Indo-Pacific and we look forward to continuing to develop our relationship with the government and the people of this country," unquote.
Let me draw your attention to some more local news. News first, received footage of two turtles who were washed onto the shore of the Akkarai beach in Achuveli in Jaffna.
The incident is a result of seawater coming into the low-lying areas in Jaffna due to the prevailing weather condition.
Testifying at today's Presidential Commission of Inquiry to investigate into the alleged inquiries at Sri Lankan Airlines, Sri Lankan Catering and Mihindlanka was Head of Investigation at Sri Lankan Airlines, Sajith Vinodaheba.
It was revealed at the commission today that in May 2010, 34 individuals had travelled to Germany without proper documentation, and according to the witness, these 34 individuals had not returned to Sri Lanka. The witness states that no investigation was conducted regarding this matter and the airlines does not have any record of this incident. In another incident reported in November last year, Sri Lankan Airlines had permitted 5 passengers to travel to Germany despite a warning issued by the German Embassy of Sri Lanka over a possible counterfeit. Meanwhile, former Governor of the Central Bank of Sri Lanka, Ajit Nivad Kabral, arrived at the Presidential Commission to record a statement today.
Allianz Platinum Awards 2018.
I was able to win in Asia as the para-athlete and it wasn't difficult for me. I am the runner-up for the 100-meter and 200-meter sprint event in Asia. Winning the Platinum Award is not going to be easy, but I will succeed in that challenge. I am Upul Indiga.
Indiga.
Sports First, Allianz Platinum Awards 2018.
In sports news, Tilanga Sumithipala says that he will not contest in the SLC elections.
Tilanga Sumithipala expressed the following views during a media briefing held in Colombo today.
As a politician in this country, my opinion was that to go forward, the former president and the current president must join forces. I stand by my opinion. I believe that we have the duty and the responsibility beyond cricket. Duties and responsibilities that we must fulfill for our country. Therefore, I decide not to be part of the Cricket Council election and to focus on my political career to fulfill my duties to the country.
The former chairman also expressed the following views.
Today, the Asian Cricket Council office has been removed from Sri Lanka. Only the board and the office premises remain. We are very sad about this. No effort was taken to prevent this situation. We are the institute that have the control of more than $1 million annually. Our sports minister has been to the ICC office thrice within a period of 6 months. I am deeply saddened and disappointed by the fact that Faizal Mustafa couldn't keep the Sri Lankan office of the Asian Cricket Council.
Four nominations for the post of chairman were presented at the SLC elections, and they are Mohan De Silva, Jayanth Dharmadasa, K. Madhivanan and Shami Silva. Any objections against the nominations should be made before 3 p.m. on the 31st of this month.
Also in sports news, the sixth week of the Inter-Club Rugby League came to a close last evening with one team remaining unbeaten.
After 6 weeks of exciting display of rugby, Kandy Sports Club proved to be too good as they remain unbeaten after they defeated Havelock Sports Club 31-21 at Nithavella, which eventually ended Havelock's unbeaten run. At another game, Navy sank in their own backyard as CHNFC defeated them 34-26 in Valisera. Meanwhile, Police won 41-19 against Army last evening, and CRNFC got the better of Air Force 36-24 on Friday.
That's all the news we have for you this evening, but before we go, a reminder that you can also come here, be a part of this Christmas experience we have set up for you at Echelon Square in Colombo. Here we have anchors coming in and reading their bulletins live for you. You can be a part of this experience, and we also have our sister channels Yes FM and Legends FM on one side of Echelon Square set up just for you to come here and for your experience, Dasuni.
Definitely, Chaturanga. I think everybody can come and be a part of this and truly make your Christmas more magical this season.
That's all the news we have for you. As I mentioned, I'm Chaturanga Hapuarachi.
And I'm Dasuni Athava. Good night.